And welcome back to the last episode of Is Agenda 2030 Really About Equitable Development? Again, I'm your host, Thabang Selepe. And then in this episode, we are going to expand from the previous episode, which looked at how the Sustainable Development Goals are being affected by the pandemic. The results will depart from everyday practices and experiences during the pandemic, which will be an analysis built on observed practices and form of basis for our understanding on how sustainable development interconnect and are affected by the pandemic. Rethinking environmental education in the pandemic. Many educational organizations rely on international projects for traveling and exchange, among other activities. Due to the lockdown and travel restrictions, many projects have been delayed or cancelled. This made stakeholders rethink if traditional project procedures had to be continued under the conditions of COVID-19. Questions were raised as follows. Is it truly important for young people to travel around for short-term project? Organizations were pressured to find situations such as the QG Enviro, a local organization in Lis, Italy, working on environmental education and awareness, which is reorienting towards sustainable agriculture and tourism for resilience to unexpected events. With the COVID-19 pandemic, everything changed. Their two main EU projects were delayed. Many others did not start at all, and all local activities were shut down. The organization was able to migrate much of the work online. Forced home office work and its effect on health, gender, and equality. This section addresses the work related to impacts of COVID-19 pandemic management, mainly referring to the forced home office arrangement in Germany. Before the beginning of the pandemic, approximately 40% of the employed workers had the opportunity to use home office as self-chosen work flexibilization option, whereas approximately 60% had no home office option. During the second quarter of 2020, this relationship was inversed, with the lockdown regulation suddenly turning workers' flexibilization option into home office obligation. Handling the lockdown most efficiently while obtaining productivity demanded technological adjustment on different levels, such as telecommunication infrastructure, cloud technology, and workplace technology. In addition, encompassing adjustment in labor relations and laws needed to be undertaken in a rather short timeline. The individual worker in a forced home office environment had to ensure that working conditions, personal skills, and digital competences were set up to meet the new requirements of digital corporations and co-creation. However, at the time, workers found their professional, their social, and their private life more than ever forced into digital working environment. While the radicalness of the change toward home office work did not allow enough time to cope with challenges appropriately, this large-scale invasion of work into private sphere, accompanied by increased technological complexities, created new stressors for the individual dealing with situation, in addition to coping with the radicalness of the imposed change as such. While some workers found themselves at their home office condition set up adequately to achieve their task, many others were confronted with various obstacles, including the missing of separate home office working space, technical difficulties, work overload, extra burden through child caring, homeschooling, or caring for dependents. Implication for consumption and production. The Sustainable Development Goal 12, which states ensure sustainable consumption and production patterns. It's one of the most transversal in design because it includes a wide range of topics such as efficient use of natural resources, minimizing the loss and waste of food, ecological management of chemical throughout their life cycle, solid waste management, sustainable public purchases, sustainable tourism, environmental education, and finally the elimination of fiscal incentive for fossil fuel, which can distort the market. It allows a broad spectrum of action and the participation of actors from multiple sectors. Goal 12 is highly related to both the procedure, the producer and consumer, indicating the dependency of better product and increased awareness of the demanders. The pandemic appears to have cast a spotlight on the systemic inequality. For instance, Latin America and the Caribbean are in a weaker position than many other countries. Before the pandemic, Economic Commission for Latin America and the Caribbean predicted that the region would grow by approximately 1.3 in 2020. Because of the crisis, a fall in GDP of at least 1.8, is expected. Moreover, because of self-isolation and social distancing, decreased working hours and wages, the demand for goods and services is reduced. The impact in many economic sectors, mostly in services that are highly interrelated with gatherings, is significant. At the same time, it can be an opportunity to shift the way things that are done. The consumer market is more fragile because of the pandemic. People are more interested in their impact, buying more locally to help companies and individuals nearer to their communities. The sensitivity of the consumer is increased, having in the magnifying glass companies and public sector demanding more responsibility for their actions and recovery plans, which is either applauded or taunted. Global implications for mobility and climate. The pandemic has accelerated environmentally friendly mobility measures, and a shift in public mobility and cars-free cities is being highly discussed in policy circles. During the lockdown, air pollution dropped by 60% global, and bike used increased by 129%. Cities around the world are turning to non-motorized transport alternatives to help solve congestion and pollution issues. The global response to the pandemic has caused a sharp decrease in greenhouse gas emissions and an increase in air quality. Carbon dioxide emissions are predicted to increase by 8%, which would bring carbon dioxide level to those of 10 years ago. For most of the first world countries, they have been doing a good job in achieving the target set to achieve the sustainable development goals. However, for developing countries, mostly in Africa, it has been a problem because of their lack of technological and pharmaceutical advancement. The pandemic, therefore, just made things worse for such countries. However, not all things are bad. There are some of positive outcomes that were forced by the pandemic, which includes the reduced emission of greenhouse gases into the environment and the forcing of education services to be online, which is where the world is currently heading. So the pandemic actually helped the world achieve some of their objectives. With that being said, we have come to the end of this episode and the end of the show. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank everyone who has been with us, and I hope you enjoyed and found the show to be informative. Thank you and goodbye.